So our cherry blossoms will end up looking like this. If you're in the classroom, you have a piece of paper with the cherry blossom tree already there. If you're at home, you can draw one of those by drawing two lines and then having it branch out and get smaller as it moves out. Coloring in the shape. We can add more. The ones closer to back here will be a little bit thicker and they get smaller as they move out. Okay. For people in the classroom, and once you have the tree branches drawn, to make the flowers, what you're going to do, so you have a little bit of tissue paper. If you're at home, you can find some pink paper, or you can draw. And you're going to crumble it up, not so that it's teeny tiny, but just so that it has a little bit of texture. And you're going to put some glue on the paper and stick it down. And you're going to focus on the outside branches, the outside parts, not way back here. There's not usually flowers that grow back here. They grow right out to the end. So take another. Crumple it up, put a little spot of glue out to the edge, and stick it down. And I'm not smushing it all the way down. I'm letting it stand up from the paper a little bit. And I'm not gluing it down flat like that. That doesn't look like a flower. But if we bunch it up a little bit, then it does. You can also, if you want, tear the tissue paper and get some different again, I'm not smushing it totally flat. I'm letting it stand up from the paper. If you're at home and you don't have tissue paper or other pink paper, you can very easily just draw some little flowers up here. You don't have to be perfect at all. You can even just do X's.